Good morning, First Church. Good morning. Oh my gracious, we're slow this morning. Are you letting the weather bother you? Good morning, First Church. Amen. Praise the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Hallelujah. We're just happy to be here this morning. If you're online, God bless you. I'm giving you a virtual hug. I have to give a virtual hug every day. So I'm giving you 100 virtual hugs this morning. Amen. Just happy to see all of you here. Bless the name of Jesus. Won't you bless the name of Jesus with me? Let's come bless the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, First Church. Good morning.
Good morning.
No, I'm sorry. Now I know people down the street, as Kevin said, can hear me. Let's try that again. Good morning.
Good morning.
All right, that was much better. You know, we woke up this morning. We got to get excited about that this morning. Let's give God a hand just for being God. I know some of the members of the horn section aren't here today, but if we got some horns, you know, y'all go ahead and honk. All right. Yes, I heard somebody. Thank you. All right, horn section. There we go. Boom. All right, it is in the precious name of Jesus that we greet you this morning. How many of y'all are happy to be here today?
Yes.
Yes, we're excited that you are here today. If you're online with us on Facebook or later on YouTube, we're excited you're here with us. If you're a first-time guest with us virtually, please announce so in the comment section or in the chat. We definitely want to recognize your presence. If you're a first-time guest that's here with us live, we want you to stand or raise your hand. We have a gift for you. We want to recognize you this morning. So if you're a first-time guest live, we want you to stand or raise your hand so we can acknowledge you today.
Amen.
All right, we give God praise for you. We're excited that you are here. Good morning. We hope that the Holy Spirit moves in a mighty way and blesses your socks off in ways that only God can. So church, let's welcome our new guest with us this morning. Yeah. Welcome, welcome, welcome. All right, as we get started today, we have just a couple of announcements. First, that virtual Sunday school is going on. I know that the middle and high group starts, I think it's at 2:30, and the elementary group is what time?
12:30.
12:30, fantastic. So that's been going on. I got to hang out with them a couple of weeks ago with the middle and high group. That was a lot of fun. And we had a youth game night last week. Had a great time with that too, a lot of fun. So we're excited about what God is doing with our youth of all ages. We're very excited. And a special announcement for those of you on Facebook and YouTube and those of you live. Next week, as we get into the fall and really get into cooler temperatures, we are starting at a new time. New time. Everybody say new time.
New time.
Right. Say it again. New time.
New time.
Make sure you set your clocks. Make sure you're ready because we're not going to be here at 9. We're going to be here at 10 o'clock starting next week. So 10 o'clock. Everybody say 10 o'clock.
10 o'clock.
Yeah. So we'll see you next week at 10 o'clock. All right. Let's have a great day. That's it. Say it again now.
10 o'clock.
Hello. Come on now. All right. So we give God the praise for each of you. We're excited you're here. Let's have a blessed Sunday in Jesus' name.
Amen. I don't know about you all, but I like being out here on a sunny day and under God's sky. So as we gather to begin our worship, let's open with a prayer. Gracious and mighty God, we have gathered on your ground. We have gathered to give you praise today, to honor you, and to beg you to stay with us and teach us every single day. As we come into your world, we will make it better. So as we gather, give all your praise, all your worship, and all your love to our Father in heaven. We ask you now to honor everyone here and to come into each of our lives and send us the way you would have us go. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Are you ready for praise and worship?
Amen.
Are you ready for a little clapping of hands?
Yes.
And dancing of the feet?
Amen.
Amen. I'm ready. Praise the Lord.
Said to Moses, you speak to us,
and we will listen. But do not let God speak to us, or we will die. Moses said to the people, do not be afraid, for God has come only to test you and to put the fear of him upon you so that you do not sin.
Good morning. Coming to you this morning, could you please stand if you are able here and in our virtual world? And if you're in your cars, let's open our hearts up to the gospel lesson this morning, coming from Matthew chapter 21, verses 33 through 46. Listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, but put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect the produce. But the tenants seized his slave and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again, he sent other slaves, more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, they will respect my son. But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, this is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance. So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Now, when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, he will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time. Jesus said to them, have you never read in the scriptures? The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes. Therefore, I tell you, the kingdom of God will be taken away from you and given to a people that produces the fruits of the kingdom. The one who falls on this stone will be broken to pieces, and it will crush anyone on whom it falls. When the chief priests and the Pharisees heard these parables, they realized that he was speaking about them. They wanted to arrest him, but they feared the crowds because they regarded him as a prophet. The word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. You may be seated.
The Lord give it.
And the Lord take it away.
Amen. But this time, the Lord give it. And blessed
be
the name
of the Lord.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord. We have some eggs after service that you're more than welcome to. Amen. But we have that for you. We have so much for you.
Amen.
But I just want to share with you one story this week when we went out to deliver the midday lunch. And I know that Jim was blessed, and I know Cindy was blessed, and Dippo. I know they were blessed. A young man came to pick up his lunch. And he reminded me of a story in the Bible where the man went to Jesus and began to question Jesus about the kingdom of heaven.
Yeah.
He came to the van and he started questioning us about what we were doing. He complimented us. And he told us a little bit of his story. One of the things he said he asked us for was prayer. He said, I want to change my life.
Amen.
He said, I want to change my life. And he said, in the midst of saying that, I said to him, next week we'll bring you a Bible. And we bring you some reading material, some devotion material.
Amen.
And he said to me, you know, God has a way of showing you who people are. Amen. He said to me, you're going to bring me some literature. I said, yes, I am.
Come on.
Because when he said that, I knew that he was familiar with the church.
Amen.
And what God can do.
Yeah.
He just needed somebody just to touch him and to pray for him.
Yeah.
And that's what we did. We prayed for him right there. It didn't make a difference who he was. The only thing we knew, that he was a son, he was a son, he was the son of God. And he too was searching. Amen?
Amen.
Listen, every bit we give back to the church, help us with those who are searching. Church, is time for tithes and offerings. I'm gonna call in my sister who's Banke, can you come and bless the offering before they come and pick up the baskets? I just feel that we need to bless the baskets right now. You know, because there are so many people that's riding on us coming out on Tuesday. They're looking for that van on Tuesday. And they're just not looking for lunch. But they're looking for Jesus Christ. Amen. So when we offer the upper room now, we just don't offer. When we order the upper room now, we're going to stop ordering 200. And we're going to start ordering more so that we have literature, the word of God, to pass on. Amen. Amen.
Good morning, church.
Good morning.
It's such a pleasure to be in the house of God. We woke up this morning. God has been good to us. And so, out of the abundance of what he has given us, I know so many people give their offering and tithe online. If you are thinking about what and who to give, we just had a story of how many people are out there that needs your help. So give as you are able. Let us pray. Almighty Father, creator of both the physical and spiritual realm, Father, we just thank you, we praise your name, we glorify your name. We thank you, Father, that you woke us up this morning. Some people are sick there in the hospital. They could not, even if they wanted to come in, to come and worship physically with us, they cannot. But you made it possible for us. And for those who are at home, Father, we just thank you. We praise your name. Now, as we want to give out of what you have given us, Father, we thank you that we may give as you want us to give. Because your word said you love a cheerful giver. Let us give out of what you have, out of how you have provided for us. Father, we thank you, we praise your name, we glorify your name. And we know there are so many other people who wants to give, but for one reason or the other, they are not at this time. Father, we pray. We pray that you will provide for them, that they will give. Father, we just thank you for our health, for all that you have done for us. And we pray for those who are sick and in the hospital, that you will touch them now and heal them. Father, you know what's going on about COVID-19. And we pray that you will just, we thank you that you take control. Yes, Father. Thank you, Father, as we bring out of what you have given us. And we believe in faith that you have answered our prayers. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Let the children of God say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
I just like a nice amen for a change.
Amen.
Somebody say amen.
Amen.
Act like we're in the sanctuary.
Amen.
Amen. Act like you're not a little bit chilly. Act like you're warm. Act like it's 80 degrees out here. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Some of you move around a little, you get a little bit warmer. Amen. Praise the Lord. Before I get started this morning, we had a wedding 2 weeks ago. 2 weeks, right? Y'all been married 2 weeks back? Yeah. Amen. We have with us this morning, I'm going to call them up so we can show them off. Won't y'all come right on up? Come on up. Margaret and James Welling. Introduce you all to them. And you know Brother James. Brother James, haven't missed a Sunday. You missed last Sunday, Brother James. Huh? Okay. All right. And so Brother James is usually he's here every Sunday, and except last Sunday. And he sits on the right-hand side with his son.
That's right.
You know, so we give God praise and thanks for him. And his new bride, Miss Margaret.
Amen.
She hails from Philadelphia. She's coming from Philadelphia. But now she'll be ours.
All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Now she'll be ours. So we welcome her into the household of God.
Yes.
We welcome you into our First Church. I met your pastor. Love her. But she also know that you're going to be mine.
Amen.
Amen. So we give God thanks and praise to both of you. And may God bless your marriage. May you live in harmony, joy, and peace. And may you be loved forever and ever.
Amen.
May God bless you all. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Can you pray with me this morning? Gracious God, we come before your holy presence right now. We come to give you thanks and praise for all you have given to us and for all you have done for us. But Father, before I even utter a word this morning, I pray for our president. And Lord God, I feel solid in praying for him this morning. Because you say somebody has to share the word of God with everyone.
Amen.
And somebody needs to share the word of God with him in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
That we all are your children. We all belong to you. And oh God, none of us is greater than the other. Amen.
Amen.
We pray that his body will be healed in the name of Jesus. We pray no more suffering for he or his spouse in the name of Jesus. We pray, oh God, that he will come out of this COVID and he will be even better than he was before.
Amen.
That is our prayer. Lord God, we thank you for this great country. We thank you for this nation. We pray this morning for everyone who might be touched right now with COVID. Lord God, we pray no more ventilators in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Oh God, we pray for healing right now in the name of Jesus.
Yes.
We know that you can do all things. All things, not some things, but all things. You are the healer, the great physician. You are the mind regulator. You are the heart fixer. Oh God, you're everything. We give you thanks and praise. And may the words, oh God, this morning touch our hearts. And may they touch us. May they give us food for the upcoming week. That when we run into another brother or sister that say, I want to know who Jesus is, we can share the word with them. Lord God, we magnify you this day because you're worthy to be praised. In the name of Jesus, amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
And this morning you heard the word of God that was read so eloquently. And the Old Testament, the reading was, about the Ten Commandments. Anybody say anything?
Amen.
The Ten Commandments.
You all know that the Ten Commandments are important, don't you?
Yes.
But most people don't remember what they are. Pastor, don't say that. I learned it in Sunday school. But most people don't remember the Ten Commandments. And after all, we're Christians under grace and not under the law. We're saved by grace through faith. We're not saved by keeping the law. After all, we don't follow all the other 613 or so commandments in the Bible now, do we? Most of us, we eat pork. We eat fish without fins and scale. As a matter of fact, I love crabs. And we eat them regardless of the doctor tells us if we have to watch our cholesterol or not. We don't follow most of the dietary practices and clothing law now, do we? Do we just throw them all out and go with Jesus' two greatest commandments? Is that what we're doing? Yes, Lord. Love God and love your neighbor. But Jesus said, I came not to abolish the law, but to fulfill the law. So what do we Christians do with the Ten Commandments? Should we memorize them, or better still, Margaret, this is not for you. Or better still, should we get new member in our new membership class to memorize the Ten Commandments before they enter the church? Or should we put them on a nice looking plaque and put them with the church history? Amen. Just saying. Just saying. Is that where they belong? It seems sometimes as if the Ten Commandments are in a distant land. And it's only required by those people in the Old Testament. But I want to share with you about Paul this morning. Paul, my brother Paul. Paul who went to the synagogue every Sabbath day. Paul, he was a scholar and a law man. And he was a prophet. Paul, he was a teacher. He was even a board certified Pharisee and he specialized in keeping the letters to the law. He kept them to a T. Paul was also a champion of salvation by grace through faith. In fact, Paul seems to be the one who coined that phrase describing how we are saved through Jesus Christ. He wrote extravagantly and preached in the church that he found that we are saved by a gracious gift given to us by God, a gift that he received through faith. So what else does my brother Paul say? In Philippians, he at first seemed to say the law count for nothing. After describing himself as to righteousness under law, blameless, he said, yet whatever gains I have, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. He goes on, and he even went on a little bit further, and he said, everything is lost because of the surpassing value of knowledge in Christ Jesus, my Lord. Later, he referred to that previous life as the law keeping, as absolutely nothing. He has kept the law, but he considered that lost because of Christ. Paul said, I found something so much better than the law. He said, I found Jesus Christ, who suffered on a cross for my sins and paid it all for me. So for Paul, Paul is more valuable than he said. Jesus is more valuable than the law. You see, the difference that through Jesus we have new life.
Amen.
We have new life through Jesus. Paul has done about as good as a person could at keeping the law, and he did not find new life through the law. However, when he put his faith in Jesus Christ, he realized that he had a new life.
Amen.
When we put our faith in Jesus Christ, we realize that we have new life. Let me tell you, you have to keep the law. But I want you to put your faith in Jesus Christ. The new life we experience now is only a foretaste of eternal life that is beyond this mortal existence. Oh, I always say to you, I want to see Jesus one day. I'm living this life so that I can see him one day. But Paul wrote, I want to know Christ and the power of his resurrection and the sharing of his suffering by becoming like him in death. In other words, Paul said, when I die, I want to see Jesus. It's something I might not know now, but when my time comes, Paul says, I want to sit there with Jesus. I want to be with him forever. And he is willing to suffer for the new life, not to suffer because he can, but he's willing to suffer for the new life. So we are the Ten Commandments, and we say they're ancient, but I don't want you to think about them as being ancient. I want you to think that they lead us into grace through Jesus Christ. What is God's will for his people? You ever thought about that? What is God's will for you? He said, have no other gods before me. Make no idols. Don't use the Lord's name wrongly. Keep the Sabbath. Make it holy. Anybody like to worship? Keep the Sabbath. Make it holy. Said, honor your parents. I don't care what they do. Honor your parents. Do not murder. Do not commit adultery. Do not steal. Do not bear lie against your neighbors. We all know our neighbor is the one that's living next door to us only. But our neighbors is everybody. Do not covet. So the Ten Commandments help us to be faithful to the call of Jesus Christ. Jesus calls us to be righteous and loving and worship God. These 10 laws give to ancient Israel over 3,000 years ago help us to understand God's will for our life. They don't save us, but they help us to be faithful, and they help us when we come into worship, we know that we're worshiping God Almighty. They help us to know what we ought to do. Do not use the name of the Lord wrongly. Make no idols but God. In other words, don't worship your house. Don't worship your car. Don't worship your clothes, but worship God. He said, keep the Sabbath holy. Today is a day that we ought to be spending in worship, not running to the mall. Hallelujah. Amen. Nobody saying amen. Hallelujah. But it ought to be a day of rest and gladness. The songs say, oh, day of rest and gladness. Oh, day of joy and light, oh, balm of care. And it's most beautiful, most bright. Today ought to be a day where your body just slow down and you get some rest. Don't take anything that don't belong to you.
Come on.
Leave it alone.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't tell something about somebody that's not true and you know it's not true and it might bring hurt and harm to them. Don't covet anybody that's not your wife or your husband. Oh, hallelujah, Pastor, you should have said that. Don't covet anybody that's not your wife or your husband. Leave them alone. Go get your own. Amen. Oh, they're going to, you said they're going to get rid of next week. I'm gone. Don't covet anybody that's not your wife or your husband. And get your own. The Ten Commandments are there to keep us in line. But grace comes from God Almighty. Don't fall into the trap of trying to save yourself by keeping the Ten Commandments only, but do look to them. If you have given your life to Jesus Christ and have been saved by the blood of Jesus Christ, then you will want to gratitude and love, and you would want to live in peace with your neighbor. The Ten Commandments help us to serve God and serve him fully and right. So love God. Worship Come on, somebody, worship with me. Worship. Worship him alone. Respect him. Don't take his name in vain. Amen. But love the Lord your God with all your heart, your mind, your soul, and your spirit. And love your neighbors as you love yourself. That means no matter what, my kids that's coming across the field, right, the campus right now, I have to love them the same as I love myself, or even greater.
Amen.
Amen. My sister that sits under the tree right now, I have to love her greater than I love myself, because God told me that's what I ought to do. Love the Lord your God, but love your neighbor as you love. If you don't know how to love yourself, you can't love your neighbor. So let me again say, love yourself. Love yourself so you can love. You can love abundantly. Jesus said he came not to abolish the law, but to fulfill the law. Put your faith in Christ Jesus, and he will enable you to be faithful in all your days. Amen?
Amen.
Nothing will be taken away from you, but everything God will give to you.
Amen.
Worship the Lord your God with all your heart, your mind. And if I miss any parts, you know how to fill it in.
Amen.
God bless you. Amen.
Amen.
And amen. And amen. 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 I tell you, this week I was Friday mostly, and yesterday I was in a bit of a shamble. But you know, the word of God is so powerful that it can take you and shake you and put you where you belong. Amen. The word of God is powerful. And you know, sometimes we hold against folks things they've done in the past, that we can't do that. We have to look to the future. Amen. And so I want to look to the future with you this morning. I'm looking dead into the camera because I want to look to the future with those of you who might be viewing us right now. And regardless of what has happened in this country, our aim right now is to mend every fence. It's to work together as one. Whatever party you belong to, it doesn't matter right now. Our aim is to work for Jesus Christ. Amen. And right now, I need everybody to be praying for the president. I need his healing, and I need his heart to be mended. Amen. Amen. And then if you are feeling ill, if you feel ill and you think you might be coming down with something, I need you to go to the doctor. I don't know about you, but I am so tired of COVID. I am so tired of COVID. And the only way it can be taken away from us, if this country begins to pray one for another. I need your prayers this morning. I need you to pray for everybody you know and those we don't even know. My friends in Carolina, my friends in Philadelphia, my friends in Delaware, New York, or wherever you might be this morning, I need you to be praying with us as one church. Will you just lift your arm to Jesus right now as we begin to pray? Gracious God, right now in the name of Jesus, we humbly bow before you. Because there is none like you. There is no one that can take that scar away from us. No one can heal our bodies. No one can heal our minds when our loved one goes home and we are left empty. We're left empty. Our hearts are broken. But God, right now we're calling on you to heal those broken places in our body. And God, if we're sick today, we're asking a touch from you. If we don't have food on our table, somehow I know, God, you're going to provide the food that we need in the name of Jesus. if our shelter is about to disappear from us, God, I am a witness that you will provide shelter in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
Oh, God, it's a time for touching and healing right now. It's a time for us to believe that our faith can take us through. Lord God, we need those Ten Commandments, but our faith needs to be in you, oh God. And right now, in the name of Jesus, we're putting everything in you because we know that you can set us free.
Yeah.
Set us free, Lord God. Continue to bless First Church and continue to bless its members. Continue to bless every church, oh God, in our cluster and in our community. Lord God, as we continue to provide for our community, allow us to see the fruits of our labor. Lord God, we will give you praise and we will give you thanks because there is none like you. In the name of Jesus, amen,
amen.
And amen.
Amen
and amen. 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 Listen, at the, during the week, you can stop into the office if you didn't get communion today. We'll have some consecrated so that you can have it to at home. Amen?
Amen?
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord, our God.
It is right
and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father, almighty creator of heaven and earth, on this holy day, World Communion Day, we give you thanks and praise that you have preserved us. You have kept us from harm and danger. Oh God, we thank you for the Ten Commandments and we thank you for our faith in you. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Holy, holy,
holy, holy. God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Holy are you and blessed your Son, Jesus Christ, by the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church. You deliver us from slavery to sin and death and made with us a new covenant by word and the Spirit. On the night in which he gave himself up for us, he took bread. And he gave thanks to you. He broke the bread and he gave it to his disciples and he said, take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. And when the supper was over, he took the cup. He gave thanks to you. He gave it to his disciples and he said, drink from this, all of you. This is my blood of a new covenant poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sin. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. And so in remembrance of these, your mighty act in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us as we proclaim the mystery of faith. Christ has died.
Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
Pour out your Holy Spirit on all of us gathered here. And on these gifts of bread and wine, make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. By your Spirit, make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to this entire world until Christ comes in his final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet through your Son, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit in your holy church. All honor and glory is yours, almighty Father, now and forevermore.
Amen.
And now, with confidence of children of God, Let us pray together. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. You may share with us now, or you can take it home and take it at home. The body of Christ given for you, take and eat. The blood of Christ given for you, take and drink. Amen. I so appreciate how you support your church, that you're here. I don't know if Brad can show those of you home. The cars that are lying in the parking lot, somehow we're going to try to see if we can share that with you. That how many of you have come out just to hear the word of God and just to be blessed by the presence of God on this campus. We give God praise and glory for all of you. We give God praise and glory for you being so supportive of our church in the prayer ministry every single morning at 6:45. When I come on, you're all there. You don't know how happy I am. I wait 2 minutes to come on, 2 minutes late, just so I can hear how many people are there before me and I can count how many more are coming on. Amen. And you're there and you're praying and you're thanking God just to be alive and well and for all the many blessings he's given to us. I thank you for the food ministry. I thank you for Bible studies that are still on fire for Jesus Christ. Those who still work hard in the vineyard. We might not see you, but you're out there working hard in the name of Jesus. Committed chairs. You got it together for us for charge conference so that we could turn in our information. Thank you so much. And if I never say before, thank you to the office staff who day after day come in and labor. We give God thanks and praise. I probably worked Donna Lee the hardest she's ever worked these last 2 weeks. Amen. But you know, it's this, apart from being in the office, COVID does something to us, doesn't it? It just tires us out. And I felt like I've never done, it's just hard work. It's just, I can't describe it to you. But we go home tired every day. Thank you for calling the office. Thank you for praying with us. And we try to call you on the phone. And sometimes, amen. You know, we call you on the phone just to check on you. If we don't have your numbers, we can't call you. So make sure the church has your right phone number. We send out a call for your correct number 2 weeks ago.
Yeah,
so make sure we have your right number so that we can call you. Those who are online, listen to us. Make sure. We want to call you too. You're a part of us.
Amen.
Make sure we have your correct number so we just can call and pray with you. We just want to pray with you. And we have three groups in the church. The lay servants, lay speakers, and CLMs, and Sassy, and another group. They're all calling, but we only can call if we have your correct number, if you answer the phone. We leave you messages, amen? And let me just say, thank you for calling to check on me. I don't think you know how that makes me feel, but thank you for calling to check on me and are always willing to give me a smile. I appreciate that. Listen, oh yeah, I got 1 minute. Thank you. I've got 1 minute. Oh, let me pray for you. Don't forget, we have some eggs, and we need your help at church. If you're listening to us and you didn't send your tithes in, hey, we're at the bottom of the barrel. Send your tithes in. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Gracious God, thank you for today. Thank you for how your Holy Spirit has worked. Thank you, oh God, for how you just wrap your arms around us late in the midnight hours. We can feel your loving arms.
Yes.
As we're about to leave this campus, oh God, we do not leave your presence because we need you like we've never needed you before.
Yes.
Oh God, go with us. Protect us from harm and danger. God, we're calling upon you because we love you. We love you, oh God. And we know you'll never leave us or forsake us. And now as you go, my sisters and brothers, will you go in peace knowing that God is with you. He'll always be with you. In the name of Jesus, peace be upon you. Amen and amen. Amen. Don't forget the eggs. Amen. Amen. Thank you.